Bush presented by the Door Guys in downtown Marion here on South Main Street. Thank you all so much for coming out today
for the
Peanut Push. The Peanut Push benefits the Junior Service Guild's Christmas Clearinghouse. And we're going to have some special guests coming for the next hour or so when we're on the radio. And we're going to start with our first special guest, former morning guy and guy who's done this show for 24 years because you were sick last year.
I was going to say 24 of the last 25. And I don't sound a whole lot better today.
Sorry to tell you, we don't sound good at all, Jimmy.
I know. But a little bit of a head cold, but I feel fine.
Jeff Ruth is joining us. And Jeff, of course, did the morning show at WMRN for a very long time and handled this Peanut Push for a very long time. And since I'm still very much a rookie, you know, I've only done this since, what, 96, 97?
97 is my first year. Yeah.
Well, there you go. So you and I got going the first time. But Jeffy's hosting this for a long time, and thank you for joining us. We're not only live on 1490 WMRN, we're also on a station you do a lot of stuff for, WZMO, right?
104.7 WZMO. And Tom, who's kind of who does everything, he, a month or so ago, said it'd be nice if we could kind of coordinate. And so we're kind of doing this for the, obviously it's a great community event, so we wanted to bring it to as many people as we could.
Absolutely, and we also have True Blues, WDIF, involved in the effort too. And those guys are going to be represented as well from Scott Chubbers.
I hear a sonic boom.
We do. We are being brought in by our friends from the Marion.
Jordan single mile.
And I'll tell you, there are no bigger angels when it comes to the Junior Service Guild's Christmas Clearinghouse than our friends from the Marion Area Harley Riders Association. And in just a few minutes, they are going to be presenting a check and telling everyone all the work that they have done over the last year. Literally, they do this year-round to raise money so that over 400 families, over 1,200 kids have a beautiful Christmas, and their efforts are huge. And Jeff, how long has the Harley Riders been part of this campaign?
Well, Scott Chai would probably know better than anybody.
And Scotty's getting things ready because he's got a presentation as well from the OK Cafe. Scotty, how long have you guys been doing this thing? Do you know? As long as you've been around? 15, 20 years, and it seems like every year they outdo themselves once again. So when the Harley Riders get over this way, we're going to chat with them.
By the way,
we'll get their check going.
Excuse me, by the way, if you listen to us on the internet, wherever you might be,
sure.
Mid-30s, lots of sunshine. The first or second year I did it, we did this, it was 2 degrees above zero. There was one year we had to delay it about 30 minutes because we had freezing rain overnight, and it was nothing but ice on the street. So we had actually used our picks and shovels to clear off the street. But really, the last 4 or 5 years, much like this, really nice weather.
I know. I think the last time we had crummy weather was 2018 when it poured down raw.
That was awful.
Oh, that had to be one of the
If we had moved it up an hour, we would have been fine because it started to rain and it poured, especially that last 20 minutes or so.
Horrible. I think the engineering department had to replace some equipment after that one, if I recall, fellas, because we got a lot of stuff wet. But yes, so we're going to have the Harley Riders come over. We're going to get started with them. But Jeff, tell everybody a little bit, because you are so close to what goes on with the Junior Service Guild's Christmas Clearinghouse. Tell everybody exactly how it works, why we're here, who this benefits, where the money goes, and everything.
I think better than me, we'll bring Jody Rafe up.
Jody, if you're ready, come on up. I didn't know if you wanted to get started this
sure time. Jody always gets started.
All right, so there you go. I'm gonna hand her the mic. Yes, chat with her.
She can give us a lot more details.
Good morning, Marion. Thank you so much for coming out today. A beautiful day. This year, Junior Service Guild Christmas Clearinghouse has taken on 398 families right here in the Marion area. So lots of families that we will be servicing. And with the community, the Marion Area Harley Riders, we have so many organizations that help team up with us to make this happen. So again, thank you to everyone that participates with us, that follows us, supports us. We love Marion, we love our community, and of course, what child doesn't deserve to smile on Christmas morning?
I guarantee you, Jody's gonna cry at least three times in the next hour.
But again, Marion, thank you, and at this time, I will have the Marion Area Harley Riders come up and talk a little bit about what they've done for us.
And Jody never knows the amount of the check, so this is gonna come as a surprise to everybody when they
Well, I'm gonna move up front, or actually, I'll let Jody chat with them a little bit. Jody, when you come around, I'm gonna pass the mic over to you, and this is gonna be cool. We need photos ready, we need cameras ready, because this is some huge stuff. Jody, go ahead.
Okay, the Marion Area Harley Riders, this group of people here, they are my friends.
Go get the check.
I hang out with them, I ride with them, and I love them. And the president here, Matt Garner, I'll let him talk a little bit about how they've done what they did. And guys, there is so much work that goes into what they do. So I love them, and the community loves you guys.
Thank you. Well, this all starts at the beginning of the year, trying to get corporate sponsors. They'll mail checks in. We do our toy run. You guys have all seen us out in the streets. You guys help us out a bunch. Whether it's a penny, a nickel, dime, I remember when ashtrays were full of change, but we all use debit cards now, so it's a little more difficult. But Marion's put all this back into it. It goes back into Marion. Thank you all for all your help, support, donations, even going on our toy run, having a good time with us. Let's just open a check and see what we got this year. Let's end up.
We need a drum roll.
$35,516.50.
Wow.
Thank you, Marion.
Guys, look at this. $35,515.50.
Woo!
Wow. Thank you, guys.
You guys are amazing. Give a huge round of applause for the angels that you see up here and all of the others that help them throughout the year to provide Christmas for all of these kids and these families. Guys, we can't thank you guys enough. We know it's a labor of love for all of you guys. Thank you so much. And that gets us well on the way to Jody's goal of $50,000. Is that what I heard there? We're trying to get to 50 grand.
Yeah, actually, this puts us way over, but with the amount of children we've taken on this year, we're going to roughly get around $75,000 to be able to service all the children we've taken on this year.
Wow.
Wow. And we're going to let Jody do some thank yous after a bit, but we've got some more business to take care of. Get all the pictures you guys want. We're going to have some fun. I'm not sure if we've got a couple of members of the Marion Area Harley Riders that are going to be part of the push today. We'll see when I get the list here from Tammy, and we go to that point. But yes, so I think moving on, Jody, do we want to do another check presentation and then get into the peanut push? What do you think? The OK Cafe. Scott Chauver, Clayton Tackett, their teams at the OK Cafe. We'll let Scott tell you guys the whole story on how, in fact, all the work that they do affects. Oh, you're going to come up here? That's great. Oh, yeah, that's cool. Jody, come on up. We got a check here for you here in a sec. Scott, it's all yours, brother.
Well, thank you very much. Thanks, guys, for coming out to the Peanut Push again this year. He's obviously a very worthy cause.
You're walking pretty well, considering you're coming off a broken leg.
Yeah, it's not quite 100% of health, but it's close enough. Close enough to get around for this.
Wife's birthday, right? Yeah, that's my
favorite. But I won't be pushing a peanut.
Why you weren't there.
Yep. I can tell you that much. Anyway, the Marion Area Harley Riders, I'm a part of them as well. So just can't thank those guys enough for doing all of the work that they do all year long for the Christmas Clearinghouse. And then they come out to the OK Cafe, and they come to our bike nights every week throughout the summer. And during bike nights, we do 50-50s to raise money for the Junior Service Guild's Christmas Clearinghouse as well. Well, and I want to present a check from the OK Cafe and all of the bikers in the area, not just the Harley Riders, but all of the bikers that come out to bike nights every Thursday night at the OK Cafe. And Jody, we would like to present you a check for $4,380. Thank you for all you do. You and Bev and everybody out there, we love you guys. Thank you. Oh, yeah, in case you're wondering, we past 3 years, I think, we've had Santa out at the OK Cafe, and he's coming back a week from this Tuesday. Santa, and he brings a couple of reindeer with him, too. I'm not sure which one he brings, but which ones are you bringing, Santa? Do you remember which? I can't fit all of them on the patio, but I know we can fit a couple of them anyway, so whichever ones he can get freed up and come fly in for us, we'll have them out there.
Can say the name all of the reindeer.
Oh, don't put him on the spot like
no,
that.
No, I'm not. That was a yes or no question.
He says yes, of course he can name all of his reindeer. Thanks, Jeff. Good to see you again. Paul, thanks for doing this again this year.
Always my pleasure, Scotty. Thank you. Everything you guys do at the OK Cafe. Love it, and cool. So, by the way, Santa's going to be on the radio with me Tuesday morning on Magic 95.9. We're gonna talk about some really cool stuff that Santa's got going on.
But if I could interrupt for just a second.
Oh, you can interrupt. Go right ahead, my friend.
We're going to talk Peanut Push, but go ahead and mention the Coats campaign that you're doing next week.
Absolutely. Coats for Christmas. Our collection campaign has wrapped up, and we're very, very excited to tell you that we have more coats than we believe we've ever had, and we've had some gigantic angels that have brought some wonderful things. We have brand new knitted hats and gloves and scarves, hundreds of them. We have brand new coats that were brought to us, and we're just so excited to do that. So next Saturday, beginning at 9, we'll be at the Marion Navs and St. Peter's School in Upper Sandusky. Anyone who needs a warm winter coat, stop by. No restrictions, just come by. If you need a coat, you can get a coat or two. If you've got a friend or someone who can't be there and you want to get a coat for them, come by. We've got plenty of kids' coats, and it's going to be a great campaign. And we thank the Marion Navs. We thank our friends at Kimmel Corporation who partner with us to do that. It really is a heck of a labor, and we're hoping that a lot of folks stop by and get a coat next Saturday morning beginning at 9. Thank you, Jeffrey.
Again, another event to benefit the community. That's what it's all about.
Absolutely. I say we get into the Peanut Push because the other day we met some royalty, and we're excited about that royalty because the royalty raised a lot of money. And we're going to get a number a little later for where we're at on just from the Peanut Push. But I say we get started. Jody, come on back up if you will. And we're going to introduce and bring our royalty up. We give them a seat up here on the stage so that they can sit. They get a plethora of prizes. Some of those come from, Sway's Trophy House. We get stuff from Hemmerly's Flowers and Gifts. We get things from, here's my list here, actually, from Hessler Screen Printing and more, the Columbus Zoo, Upper's Winter Fantasy of Lights. We've got all sorts of different prizes that are coming out. We have our beautiful crowns, and just a nice way for us to say thank you for all the effort that our king, queen, prince, and princess do for the Peanut Push. So, Jody, let's talk a little bit about our royalty, and let's introduce them. Would you like to start with the king, or when you start with the princess? How you want to do it? We'll start with the king. All right, so here you go. Yep, go ahead, do your thing.
Come on up, Daniel. Okay, this is Daniel Bradshaw from Pillar Credit Union, and I'm going to let Daniel talk a little bit about how he raised his money, but Daniel is our king of the 2021 Peanut Push.
He's our defending champion.
Hey, Daniel, put that on your phone.
Thanks, Jody. I'm just the head that's up here. I'm not the one that did all the fundraising. It's a result of, we do this all year round. The people that bank with Pillar, they come in, they buy candy bars, they buy peanuts, they just give a donation because they know that we're collecting for it. We've had people just drop off checks to us throughout the year as well. So really this is the result of the work that the credit union and its members and even the employees who gave significantly towards this. We really believe in this cause. It's a great one, of course, and just one of the many ways that we try to help out at this time of year right here in the Marion community. But thank you to everybody that contributed, the Harley Riders, the OK Cafe, and everybody else. This is awesome to see.
and Daniel raised $2,674. Thank you. We're gonna go ahead and crown Daniel. Thank you.
Daniel, thank you so much for that. Real quick, Daniel, why we got you here, you guys are doing something else that's really, really cool, and this week you guys cut the ribbon over at Marion Technical College for a brand new program that you guys are championing with them. Tell everybody a little bit about this week.
Sure. Marion Tech, if you haven't heard, they just started an esports program. It's competitive online gaming, and they have a brand new arena. So there's a room that's filled with high-speed computers and everything else. And when we heard about it about a year ago, we said we want to be part of this. It's something unique, it's something progressive, and it's an opportunity for people of all abilities to get involved with on their campus. So Pillar is actually the sponsor for the arena and sponsor for their team. So it's a really exciting program. I would encourage you to definitely check that out if you've got a student that's high school age or even college that is interested in gaming. There's a really cool activity and a chance for them to compete all across the region now.
Cool. I hear it's technologically as top as you can possibly get, and we've got it here in Marion, so thank you for your support of that.
Yeah, absolutely. We're happy to help.
Daniel, have a seat, my friend, for a few minutes. We're now going to move over to our queen, and our queen this year is Diane Morgan. Diane, come on up, or your representative. Is Diane here? I heard that she may not be here. We may have her representative, which I believe is Kathy, correct or no? Kathy, are you here? Oh, here she comes. Come on up, Kathy. We're gonna treat Kathy like she's Diane Morgan. Diane's at a wedding. Actually, someone who's very instrumental in the Peanut Butch is getting married today. So we're missing some folks from the Junior Service Guild.
That's like getting married on the Ohio State Michigan.
I know. It's the same type of thing. So, all right. So first of all, let's talk a little bit about Diane and what she did. Do you know some of the things that she did to raise her money? You've got the list. There you go.
I am standing in for Diane Morgan, who is out of town. She asked me to thank the following. Joe Sansoda of Sansoda's Fresh Italian for his fundraiser. All of her friends, which she strong-armed all of us, and her Avon customers. Next, Diane was chair of the food at Clearing House, and she asked me to do a happy dance. And then I had to announce the winner of the food drive, which all of the high schools and elementary schools, I think, participated this year. And the winner is Richdale. So if there is a representative from Richdale, would you please come and claim your plaque, which was donated by Sway's Trophy House. Thank you, Kevin. Is Richdale here? Well, we'll get the plaque to them. Or they can work hard and get it next year. So thank you.
Kathy, thank you so much. Diane Morgan, we're gonna let Kathy have the crown for Diane. She'll move it on, I know. And let's give a big round of applause for Diane Morgan. She raised $1,800 to be queen of the WMRN Peanut Push presented by the Door Guys. Moving on, we'll go to our prince, and our prince this year is Nate Pollock. And I believe Nate is from Harrison Elementary School. Nate, come on up, buddy. And Nate, stand over here so everybody can see you, because if you get behind my podium, they may not be able to see it. I want to ask you, how did you raise all of this money? You raised $476. What all did you do?
My mom made some flyers for me to give out to teachers at school and also to family. Yeah, and they donated money for me.
Very good. And you go to Harrison Elementary School?
Yeah.
What grade are you in?
Fifth.
And I understand you guys also won something for your class. Can you tell me about that?
It was a food drive for the whole school.
What did you win?
A pizza party.
How cool is that? Nate, thank you so much. Have a seat, young man. 407. Actually, stand up. We're going to put your crown on you. Get a good picture or two of you with your crown. You can sit back down. Don't let it fall off. Oh, the crowds are awesome. I love it. Okay, and our princesses. We have two this year, Finley and Berkeley Payne. Finley goes to Pleasant. Berkeley is in the YMCA program. And they raised $1,050 for the WMRNPF push. Grandma, tell us a little bit of the work that the girls did.
Okay, this is Berkeley, and this is Finley Payne, and they have been with me with Clearinghouse for as long as they've been born. So my children, that's all they know, is Clearinghouse, and this is how we celebrate Christmas, is giving back to our community. So Finn and Berkeley hit up all their friends and family and raised $1,050. So we love them and appreciate everything they do for Clearinghouse. Berkeley goes to the YMCA Crystal.
And they're on their way to a gymnastics competition.
And they didn't, you guys didn't want to talk? You don't want to say hi to everybody? No, Finley said, no, I'm good. Well, thank you. You guys did wonderful. We're gonna put a tiara crown on you guys so we can get some pictures. Thank you so much for everything that you've done. We left Thursday night with over $6,000 already for the peanut push. We'll see where we're at here by the end of the night. So I say, or the end of the morning, I guess. So I say we move into our heats. What do you think, Jeffrey?
Before that, I want to talk to Jody for a moment about adoptions.
Oh, okay.
Because adoptions, I know you've been adopting families out, but now it really starts in earnest. Explain what the adoption process is all about.
Absolutely. On Monday at 4:30 p.m., I will open Christmas Clearinghouse, and our location is 1680 Marion Waldo Road. And Children's Services, they donate a building to Clearinghouse every year, so that's where I will be stationed for 2 weeks. And a lot of people call me and say, hey, Jody, how can we help out? And one option is adopting a family. And when I say adopt a family, you sort of call me and you give me an idea of a family you would like to adopt. And we have families, single moms, single dads, mom and dads, lots of grandparents raising grandchildren. You will take on that family. And I have families from 1, 2, up to 8 and 9 children. So you can tell me what size family you would like, and I will give you all that information, and then you will contact that family, and you will take care of them for the holidays, and you'll provide the children with gifts and hats, gloves, mittens, new blankets, and non-perishable food items. So that's one option of helping Clearinghouse, as well as collecting items. A lot of organizations, businesses will collect items, and that could be non-perishable items, blankets, hats, gloves, mittens, new toys, and of course monetary donations. So there's lots of options of how you can help Clearinghouse. You can also reach me at 740-341-5871 if you just have some other questions about what you can help, you know, what you can do to help Christmas Clearinghouse out.
And one more thing, I was helping Diane yesterday a little bit, packing up food and so forth. Can people still bring in food?
Oh yes, absolutely. Like I said, almost 400 families we're going to be servicing. So lots of food, you know, needed, you know, to make sure every family gets a nice food box for the holidays.
All right, terrific. And again, we can't say it enough how much you mean to the community for what you do to put this together. You told me 20 years ago, I'm going to do it for another year or so.
You know, sometimes you find something that just you love. And, you know, something like this, giving back to our community, as well as what child doesn't deserve to smile on Christmas. So, again, thank you for the community.
And how many people are here for the first time?
Let's hear from you. We're on the radio, so let's hear from you if you hear the first time. There you go. All right. We're going to let Jody do a ton of thank yous after we do the actual peanut push. She's got a lot more to say, and we're going to do that here in just a few minutes. Right now, though, I say we move on with our heats. What do you think, Jeffrey?
I think we might as well start.
All righty. And with that being said, I want to thank you, Jeff, and I also want to thank our friends from True Blues 97.5. Silky Ray, come on up, Silky. I want to have you help us do the peanut push. Because
this guy doesn't have a radio voice.
We decided, oh Lord. All right, can you get out of your guard, brother? You need a hand? And seriously, We all got together. If there's one thing I can tell you about this group is we've all worked together in one way, shape, or form for a long time. And we've all worked on this program for a long time. And now we're all kind of doing some different things, but we're all working on the same goal. And we got together not too long ago and decided it was great for us to do this all together and make sure that our end goal is raising a lot of money for the Christmas Clearinghouse. Ray, thank you so much for all the things that you did on the radio to get people excited about the Peanut Push again.
You know, the whole thing is all about community. And you know what? Marion is a fantastic community. Give yourselves a hand. Jeff, I'm always there to see
you. Well, you got me.
Yep. And Paul
Jane. Well, it's always good to see Jeff.
Oh, yeah. Mr. Peanut.
I met him with
Mr. Peanut. He's a stand-in for Mr. Peanut. Yes, indeed. And Paul James, me and Paul have been friends for many a year. Jeff, myself, Scotty. He's somewhere running around right now. But the radio community in Marion is a strong, knitted family. All of us get along, we have a great time. And you know what? Y'all make it happen.
Brother, thank you so much. You can hang out and help us call this thing if you want. Stay up here. The reason why, of course, right off the bat, because this guy gets pushed peanut right off the bat. All right, so our first heat. Now, if you don't know anything about the peanut push, this was started in 1969 by Charlie Evers. And Charlie Evers at the time was doing the morning show at WMRN. Jeff, tell the story of how the peanut push got going and what you were telling me earlier today.
Well, a listener called in and basically challenged Charlie to raise money for the clearinghouse. And there were a couple different things. They were going to get in a bathtub and see who could row the farthest. They were all different kinds of things, but they finally agreed to a parade. It started out at WMRN and ended up with Matthews Kennedy. So that was a long parade back then. And then they pushed the peanut. Gil Gomez, who was a meteorologist, who did the weather back then, and they kind of pushed a peanut to raise money for the clearinghouse, and it just kind of took off. And then Charlie left in 80, and so it went away for a little while, and then when he came back in 1990, kind of brought the peanut push back, and we've been doing it ever since. I can't imagine not having a peanut push now after all these years.
I know, and then he retired and handed it off to you, and you've been here ever since, and so the heritage of this is phenomenal, and you know, God bless Charlie for everything he did, and just an unbelievable human being, and we all miss him, and you could just run down the list of wonderful things he did for this community, and we're just trying to keep things going, aren't we?
Absolutely.
Hi, I'm Gracie Thompson here at the Peanut Push, and I'm here today with
Todd Schneider.
So, Todd Schneider, tell me a little bit about what we're doing here today.
All right, this is the Peanut Push. This is a to raise money for the Christmas Clearinghouse to help families in need at Christmas. The Junior Service Guild is one of the people that put it on, as is the Christmas Clearinghouse. It is a great tradition here in Marion where local dignitaries, citizens, try to push a peanut across the street, which is part of the festivities. It's pretty fun, pretty neat, and it's a beautiful Saturday morning here in December in Marion, Ohio.
So, Tasha, do you have any shout-outs that you would like to give, Christmas shout-outs or anything?
Absolutely. I want to give a shout-out to all of the staff members in Marion City Schools, and most of all, to all of the teachers in our country right now who are educating children through what has been a rough, really, last couple years. Keep grinding, keep working, everybody. Our kids need us. They need our love. They need our support. They need our understanding, and we have the most important job in America.
All right, thank you so much for joining me today.
Absolutely.
We're trying to push not only a peanut, but everything, right?
Everything we can push. That's right. There you go. I'm ready.
All right, let's do it. All right, let's do it. Okay, so in heat number one, pushing a peanut across the street will be Daniel Bradshaw from Pillar Credit Union, Kyle Strzelecki from the Ridgedale Lions Club, Michelle Fouts, a McKinley assistant principal, Wes Blanton from the Marion Area Harley Riders Association, and Jeff Ruth representing the Door Guys and WZMO Radio. I'm going to hand you this mic. Since Jeff gave this one up, to all do right. the peanut push. All right, are our nut busters ready? So we've run our nut busters out across the line there, and you guys make sure everybody has a peanut. Make sure they've got a peanut. And then our nut busters also keep an eye when they have a peanut that breaks or explodes or whatever, set down another peanut for them. And this is a race. We'll do three heats. We're going to end up, I think we'll have, what, two come out of each heat? Let's do that. So the top two out of each heat is going to move on to the final. It's Wes Davis. Okay, I gotcha. I gotcha. I'm going to switch that on my sheet.
Okay. Actually, this is the most perfect shot I could get.
The key is to finish third, Jeff. Absolutely.
Hey, do you know who this guy is right here in one position?
Talk to me. That is Daniel Bradshaw.
Yeah, the funk master of finance, Dan Bradshaw. Yes, indeed.
All right, if you guys are ready and all of our nut busters are ready with peanuts, we go right to that line. Oh, there goes Santa.
Slowly make your way around.
Oh, my God.
He's everywhere.
I know him. All right, here we go. Get your nose behind a peanut. We'll start in 3, 2, 1, go.
And now,
she's an assistant
there you go,
principal
Marion.
At elementary
yes,
school.
Indeed. Look out, look out, look out, look out.
So Daniel's already through and done and coming back the other way. Come on, Jeff, we want you second.
Oh,
is Jeff trying not to be second? What do you think?
I think so.
Michelle's doing well right now.
Next, Jeff.
We have Wes Davis, who's really, really hopping for number two. Let's see if it's going to be Wes. Michelle. Michelle's like, please make it be Jeff. But Michelle wants it to be Jeff, so I think Jeff got second. What do you think? Michelle, what do you think? Did you have fun? She got third.
There you go.
Get a little help from Santa. Yeah. Gotta have some help from Santa. All right, so.
Okay, you ready?
Okay. So Daniel was one, and Jeffy was two.
Hi, everybody.
I'm here today at the Peanut Push with
Miss Musbach from Harding High School.
Hi, Miss Musbach. So tell us a little bit about what we're doing here today.
So we are here for a good cause to support the Christmas Clearinghouse and Jody Reif and the community of Marion.
Do you have any Christmas shout-outs that you would like to give to anybody?
I need to give a Christmas shout-out to our new assistant principal, Joanne DeNoro, in his inaugural peanut push. He has just qualified for finals, and we're very proud of Mr. A and his efforts today for the peanut push.
All right. Thank you, Ms. Musbach. Thank you for joining me today.
Two, and I believe we're going to make sure that she's moving on to the other heat. Okay, so there you go. So now we're going to heat number two. Jeff, you all right? You didn't break your glasses. Remember one time you broke your glasses? Yeah. He probably does. I remember one year he broke his glasses and he's like, I can't read my stuff. All right, so Ray, we're going to move on to heat number two.
All right.
And first up is contestant number six, the mayor of Marion, Mr. Scott Schertzer.
There he is.
And contestant number seven is Kirk Detweiler, the new executive director of the Marion Palace Theater. Kirk. Number eight is that Joe Anderson from Marion City School? Is that what it looks like to you?
Andora.
Okay, so there you go. Andora. Andora. Okay, Joe Andora, come on up. Teresa.
Most people don't even know what his name is.
Lupton, number nine from the Civitan Club. Teresa, come on up. And Mike Knapp from Marion City Council. He's number
eight. Yeah, Mike Knapp.
Is it Lupton? Lupton. Teresa Lupton. Teresa Lupton. All right. Hey, Jimmy.
Hey, I want to have Kirk come up just a second.
Did you realize that we were all people?
I just realized. Palestinian or
this guy was like all here.
Yeah.
Mr. Detweiler here.
Like the mayor, one princess.
Oh, okay. I was going to.
Hello, everybody. I'm here today at the Peanut Push with
The Grinch.
The Grinch. Mr. Grinch, tell us a little bit about what we're doing here today.
They invited me up to pick on everybody and make fun of people, so I'm having a blast doing what I do best.
Wow. Do you have any Christmas shout-outs you'd like to give?
Yeah, I just want to give a shout-out to Marion for all this stuff that they're doing. I mean, this is fantastic. They're bringing everything back to life, getting people out and doing all this stuff. And kids, I'm not a bad guy.
Thank you so much for joining me today, Mr.
Thank
Grinch.
Thank you for having me.
Yep.
I was going to have him put a plug in for Christmas at the Palace tonight at 7:30, tomorrow afternoon at 2 o'clock.
They're recording.
And I will be there tomorrow, and so will you, I think we were talking earlier.
And
so.
Me too.
Oh, you're going to Washington? That takes a little wind out of you.
There you go.
Well, actually, the last one, before we get your heat, he sounded really good. Now you sound horrible again. So I can only say that because it's Jeff.
Jeff started out as a peanut, now he's in the butter.
All right, let's get heat number two running. So here we go. So we've got the mayor, we've got Teresa, we've got Joe, then over there, then we have Mike Neff. Okay, so here we are. Everybody got a peanut? Everybody ready? Oh, don't worry about the mayor's number. If it comes off, we know who he is. Believe me, we know who he is, don't we, Silky Ray? All right, here we go. We'll fire in 3, 2, 1, go! Push that peanut.
Let's go,
mayor. You know, the mayor's really good at this.
Mayor,
you
look right here by nose, ladies and gentlemen.
Mayor shirts are pretty good.
Pulling the hair, he's pulling the hair. Yes, indeed, it's the mayor.
Joe's doing really well.
Mike, I believe in you.
Joanne Doyle is doing really well from Marion City Schools. He looks like he's going to be number two. Mike Neff doing well. He's in third. And Teresa from the Civitan Club. Teresa, you don't have to hold your hands behind your back. You're fine.
This is the first time I've seen
you. Oh, she's holding her glasses. Somebody else can hold her glasses for her.
Oh, bro, Mike's peanut's broken.
And you know what, Teresa? You don't have to keep going. You're good to go. We got our top two. So number one was Scott Scherzer. Number two was Joanne Morrow, I believe. Is that correct? All right, so there you go. That's going to be heat number two.
Hello, everybody. I'm here today at the Peanut Push with
Santa Claus.
Santa Claus. Santa Claus, tell me a little bit about what we're doing here today.
Well, today we're here in Marion, Ohio, supporting the Christmas Clearinghouse. It's going to help a lot of families in need here in this wonderful community. I had to be here. I had to be a part of it. So a lot of people raising a lot of money to help people and give back here to our community. It's beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Santa Claus, do you have any Christmas shout-outs you would like to give today?
Oh, boy, boy, boy. I tell you what, I want to give shout-outs to Paul James, to Jeff Ruth, to all these great people that are down here. And it's just been a wonderful, wonderful activity. And listen, a lot of great Christmas displays around Marion, Ohio. Get around here. Check out the festive holiday spirit. And enjoy being a part of this wonderful Christmas time.
Thank you so much for joining me today, Santa.
Absolutely. Merry Christmas.
Yep, Merry Christmas.
That's going to be heat number two. Wonderful. This is fun, guys. I mean, there's nowhere else in the world that does a peanut push, but we do in Marion, Ohio. All right, so heat number three. We're going to let Jeff announce this heat because I hope he got his voice back. We've got number 11, Tyler Granley from The Door Guys. Also from The Door Guys, number 12, Mike Barnett. Number 13 from The Door Guys is Phil Sprague. And number 14 is Troy Jarvis. And number 15 is Emma Thacker from River Valley Schools. So come on up.
One of those guys.
You can't tell them Door Guys work outside.
Oh, the Door Guys work outside. They're good. Thank you for the stage. Thank you guys for supporting this for a long time. They're supporting all of our high school sports that we're doing on the radio this year. We're big fans of what the Door Guys do. Absolutely are. And Tim Granley called me about a week ago and said, can you represent me? And I said, sure. So we got Tyler, Mike, Phil, Troy, and Emma.
I have no idea. It's one of those.
How old is Emma? 10 years old. Emma will thank you for coming out and supporting us.
Yeah. Your nose on the ground and not a brush. I love that.
Okay, are we still doing the brushes, by the way?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, we're still doing the brush.
All right, on your mark. Get set. Go.
Go, Emma, go. Go, Emma. Yes, indeed. She's trailing, but she's coming on strong. Yes, indeed.
It's Troy and Mike.
They're
kind of leading the way right now.
Mike is getting by. Just a nose. Yes, indeed.
Just a nose.
Just a nose. Here comes Troy. Here comes Troy.
So we got. We got Troy. We got Mike. And it may take a little while to get our third place finisher. Yeah, Troy, Mike, and I think that is Phil.
Go, Emma, go!
Go, Emma, go! Go, Emma, go! Go, Emma, go!
Come on, Emma! Yes, indeed! Yes, indeed!
Hey,
that's the future of the peanut push right there.
I think Emma's going to beat Tyler.
That's okay,
because I'm
going to
have to
move. Tyler's
okay with it, too.
Yeah, I do, too.
I think Tyler's shoes is getting in the way.
All right, good job, Emma. And good job, Tyler.
Hello, everybody. I'm back here today at the Peanut Push with
Mayor Scott Schertzer.
Mayor Scott Schertzer. So tell me a little bit about what we're doing here today.
Well, actually, we're raising money for Christmas Clearinghouse. The Peanut Push is a traditional Christmas fundraiser for the Clearinghouse that helps out underprivileged families in our community. And I've been participating in this since I started teaching at Elgin Junior High School in 1996. So it's been a lot of fun to come out and participate as a teacher, as a councilman, and now as a mayor.
All right, thank you so much. Do you have any Christmas shout-outs you'd like to give to anybody?
Well, I just want to wish everybody in Marion a very merry, safe, and happy Christmas, and just be safe out there.
All right, thank you so much for joining me today.
Good job, Tyler. All right. So this way, instead of paying $20, the kids could pay $10, because every dollar counts when you're raising money for the Clearinghouse.
You know, Jed, I'm thinking you're getting ready to give us the brush off.
Oh, okay. Yeah. You're good. We got Kylan Bland from River Valley. And we got Nate and Andrew Johnson, both representing Harrison.
This is how they push a peanut. The kids get to push a peanut with a whisk broom. We feel it's a little better for the kids. How long have we been doing the whisk broom thing? That started with you, I think, didn't it?
Oh, probably 10 years or so anyway.
Yeah, we think it's kind of cool. Gets kids involved. They get to use a whisk broom. We can spread them out a little bit along the line, yeah?
Oh, I want to
make sure we have oh, yeah, make sure they have plenty of room, because this will be fun. Oh, so we have Kylan, Nate, and Andrew. So I think we're missing one. Oh, there you go. Come on up.
Yeah.
No. Here they go.
Yeah, it would have been like.
Jeff, you want to call the kids' race?
8, 9 o'clock.
Jeff.
We can go. All right. Once again, on your mark, set, go.
He's the only one.
Kylan.
Where did they get brooms?
Kylan, I took early lead. Kylan's going to win this one. I guess.
Hey, get a job as a painter.
Nate and Andrew are right behind. So, congratulations, all three of you. And again, thanks for coming down and supporting the Peanut Push.
Okay, now we've got our finals. And in the finals, let's see if we do this right, guys. We've got Daniel Bradshaw out of the first heat. And Jeff, I'll just take your mic because you're in this. And Jeff Ruth. We also have Mayor Scott Schertzer. We have Joe Andoro from Marion City Schools. We have Mike Barnett from the Door Guys and Troy Jarvis all in the finals.
Oh, yeah.
And Tammy, we have our plaques for first, second, and third. You got them?
Oh, yeah.
So after this heat, we're going first, second, and third. They all get a wonderful plaque from our friends at Sway's Trophy House. So we'll see who our top three are in the Peanut Push.
I ain't saying that, but I think these guys are a little numb.
Yeah.
Daniel goes, I gotta have enough room. I think Vegas is giving 3-2 to Scherzer, and Daniel's about 5-2 to win.
There you go, there you go.
And Jeff's not sure where he's gonna line up. You can go down here on the end, Jeffy, because we know you're not gonna try hard on purpose. Why don't you go back behind Troy? That might, yeah. We'll make that virtual line a few feet farther for you.
Definitely is funnier.
Yeah, we don't want anybody to kick anybody in the head. We try our best, but you know that. All right, here we go. The finals of the WMR and Peanut Push presented by the Door Guys in 3, 2, 1, go! Oh, what do you think, Silky Ray? Who's your money on?
Daniel Bradshaw.
Daniel's got it figured out.
Bastard. Go, Daniel, go.
And the mayor's doing a great job. He's right behind him in second. Troy Jarvis doing well. Absolutely. Troy is doing well.
I think the mayor went lame on this, ladies and gentlemen.
So who got second, Troy or the mayor? What do you guys think?
Troy.
Was it Troy was second and the mayor was third?
The mayor pulled up lane.
So there you go. From Pillar Credit Union, Daniel Bradshaw, our winner. Number 2, Troy Jarvis, and number 3, Scott Scherzer, mayor of Marion. Congratulations. Give him a round of applause. Being done here, we're gonna finish. Let Jeff get his peanut across the line, because if he starts, he's got to finish.
Oh yeah,
that's a Jeff thing. He's got to go from one side to the other. Yep. Is he all right?
Hello, everybody. We're back here today at the Peanut Push, and I'm here with.
I'm Mr. A or Joanne DeNoro.
Mr. A, so tell me, Mr. A, what are we doing here today?
We just finished the Peanut Push. Didn't go the way that I wanted it to. Got fourth. Wanted to take home the win for Harding, but. Did my best.
Things happen. It's okay. Do you have any Christmas shout-outs you'd like to give today?
Just to the community and the school as a whole. Looking forward to it. Some time to be around family, have some fun, and get some relax.
Thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you.
Come on up, Mayor Scherzer. Trey, come on up. Daniel looks good now. He looks great in his crown.
There are all these people in the way.
There you go. Here you go, Troy. Do it.
Get a couple of pictures here. Congratulations and thank you guys all so much. Wow.
You know
what do you think of this?
You know what I say? One thing about Pillar Credit Union, they're always doing good in our neighborhood.
Absolutely, brother. You are absolutely right.
Yeah. And then, of course, we've got our scholarly center right there.
Oh, you know what? How many years have you done this, Mayor Scherzer? He's lost count, because you were doing it when you were on city council too, I think, right? Yep. So yeah, I think Mayor Scherzer's done this for maybe close to 20 years.
Oh yeah.
You and me aren't even that old, so.
Sure. I don't know about you. I got shoes your age.
All right, Jody, come on up. Let's do some thank yous, and we've got some other prizes to give out to some folks. I want to start with a few thank yous for a lot of our prizes, and we have some more prizes to give away. Once again, big thank you to Swade's Trophy House, our friends from Hessler Screen Printing and More, the T-shirts. We have plenty of T-shirts. How much are we selling them for, Tammy? A donation? If you make a donation to the Junior Service Guild's Christmas Clearinghouse, you can come up and get one of these T-shirts. Go nuts. They're awesome. They're from Hessler Screen Printing and More and the Door Guys. So we'll be here after we're done. You can come up, make a donation, and get a T-shirt. We have multiple sizes. So thanks to them. Hemmerly's Flowers and Gifts. These baskets of prizes are beautiful. Thank you so much to Hemmerly's for being part of that and helping us out again. We also have some prizes from the Columbus
Zoo. They're just doing
Winter Fantasy of Lights, some of those.
I think they
thank you to all of them.
So we had a
and Jody, why don't you run down your list?
Yeah,
you have a lot of thank yous to do, too.
Okay, before we get started, is Teresa Lupton still here?
Teresa Lupton, are you still here?
It wasn't the mayor, right?
She's not stepping up. From the Lions Club, Teresa. Civitan Club, I'm sorry. Civitan Club, Teresa Lupton.
Yeah.
Here comes Teresa, come on up.
I wanted Teresa to talk a few minutes. Her organization did fill the bus for Clearinghouse.
Oh, yes, come on up, Teresa.
Shout out and let you talk just a couple minutes about fill the bus for
You're doing just fine. Teresa, thank you. Go ahead and tell us about the Fill the Bus campaign.
Fill the Bus we do every year down at the Harding Memorial.
Marion City Schools donates a bus, and for 5 hours we stand there and make collect money and food and clothing for the clearinghouse.
Yep.
And this year we collected close to $300, plus a lot of school book, reading books, so that kids have Christmas presents that way. And Superintendent tries to help any way we can in the community, so we thank you for allowing us to do that. And the problem with my nose out here.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for being part of this. We appreciate you and everything that your organization does, the Civitan Club. Cool, good stuff.
And I can go on with thank yous, but a huge thank you to my friends at the radio station.
Well, you're always very welcome.
Teaming up with us, Scott Schauber from OK Cafe, of course, the Marion Area Harley Riders, Christmas Barbecue, the Door Guys, Pillar Credit Union, the Marion City Schools. They're my employer, but what they do for Clearinghouse and all the Marion City Schools, the county schools all come together collecting items for Clearinghouse. We would never be able to take on a project like this without their support. And of course, the community of Marion. You guys embrace this project, and I can't thank you enough. So again, I hope everyone has a wonderful holiday, and please come out and see us at the Clearinghouse at 1680 Marion Waldo Road.
You cried 4 times in 45 minutes.
I'm a crybaby.
Again, Marion's a great place to call home. And again, it's because of events like this. Thank you so much. And Paul, I'll send it back to you and we can wrap it up. Well, thanks to you, Jeff Ruth and WZMO. Thanks to Silky Ray and Scott and everybody at True Blues 97.5 for obviously everything to put everything together. It's been a great campaign. Just a thank you to everyone. The Marion Township Fire Department and their toy drive was unbelievable. But you can continue to contribute. You can drop off toys. You can drop off cash. You can buy one of these T-shirts. A donation will get you one. Whereabouts do you think we're going to be on the peanut push? Any idea?
$6,800.
All right, I'll see you.
But then we'll be figuring the Harley Riders.
Be good.
Figuring the OK Cafe. T-shirt money. What a great day. And again, I also want to thank Santa and the Grinch. So thank you guys for coming out. I appreciate it.
If we missed anybody, thank you. And thank you to the Marion community for supporting this once again. And just a great deal. We've got some prizes for some more prizes for our royalty, but we're going to get out of here. We're going to send it back to the station. Thank you guys so much. We've got the parade starting at noon. And, of course, Santa at the Exploratorium 2 to 4 today. Lots of great activities happening in downtown Marion. Thank you to them, the city of Marion, and Mayor Schertzer and everyone to help us get going. And Mike Chaney as well from the Parks Department who helped us out today as well. We'll send it back to you. It's the WMR and Peanut Push presented by the Door Guys.
Hello, everybody. We're here today at the Peanut Push, and I have beside me...
My name is Paul James from iHeartMedia.
Mm-hmm. Jody Reif, Director of Christmas Clearinghouse.
And I'm Jeff Ruth, and I've been doing this. This is my 24th year.
So tell us a little bit about what we're doing here today.
Well, this is the WMRM Peanut Push. It started back in 1969 to benefit the Junior Service Guild's Christmas Clearinghouse. And this is a culmination of events that many organizations do to raise money so that 400 families have a beautiful Christmas. And that guy over there is with an organization that does a heck of a lot of work. And that's the Marion Area Harley Riders. But Jody will talk about that.
Hi there. Hi, I'm Jody Reif, like I said, Director of Christmas Clearinghouse, and this year we are servicing 400 families in the Marion area, and today was a great day. It was the Peanut Push, and the Marion area Harley Riders come in with a huge check, and the President, Matt Garner, with the Marion area Harley Riders is here with us as well.
Do we want to bring Matt? Bring Matt in, yeah.
Join us.
You are the guy.
Talk to him about what they do with the Harley Riders.
So you want to tell us a little bit about what you do with the Harley Riders?
I'm the president this year, and we take the full year and try to get donations from corporate, from local areas, from the local committee, people driving through the streets when we do panhandling, and we just put it all together and present Marion with a check that goes back to Marion.
Do you have any Christmas shout-outs you'd like to give to anybody?
My mom and dad. Mom's here. She's over there. She's a member. And dad's in Galleon, and he'll see it on the news.
Thank you so much for joining us today.